Well, fingers crossed I'm upright. Friday, annual trip. You take a guy's trip each year. Scott, you and your buddies get together to various destinations around the country. Josh, you're known to take yourself a vacation or two, sometimes Miami, sometimes San Diego. Is there a big one planned this year for you?
I'm thinking about going to Clute, Texas.
Clute, Texas. Check in with Brandon with a Y. Got a peek at her, by the way. Member of the Clean Plate Club. Yeah. Heading to the Canaan Valley Resort. It's in West Virginia.
I'm looking at it here. It doesn't seem like the mountain is too big. It seems manageable.
It's a very medium, spiced mountain. It does have a double black. It does have a black diamond on there, which we accidentally went down the first time we were there because we didn't realize how much lift we got on, like a bunch of dummies. Myself, Tommy Simbazo, two friends of his who I have yet to meet, our buddy Sean Gabbert, he's our investment specialist, part of DLP, and Eric Woodworth.
Okay, stop. I got a lot of things I need to discuss.
Okay.
Tommy Simbazo bringing two friends you've never met.
They are snowboarders, so I guess they're good.
Is that a wild card issue, Mary?
Yeah, but in the best way possible. Tommy has a crew that he runs with that we're not. He has this.
But are
plate.
You worried that maybe things might not? You know, sometimes people don't get along or whatever. I don't know.
A friend of Tommy's is a friend of mine.
Got it. Okay,
He's got a bunch of colorful characters in his scope. Never has there been one that I've been around like,
okay, cool.
Not again with them. No. He does know some eccentric characters, but like the fun, I'm glad good. I met them type.
Yeah, because you all have a friend. They're like, oh, I'm bringing someone. You're like, ah.
No. Don't bring that one. Don't bring the one. The one that hides the bottle of Sutter Home in her purse. Don't bring her. Tommy, by the way, for those that aren't aware, leathersmith, D&D player, comedian, musician, electrician, also insane snowboarder. Rips. I mean, you got to pray to keep up with him.
Now,
he is awesome.
My other train of thought here is you are a skateboarder.
Yes.
Which is a skill I can't even go 2 feet on a skateboard. Does that translate to the mountain? And B, what is your competency on a snowboard? If Tommy is a, let's say, 7 to 8 out of 10, where are you?
I'm a 5 or 6. Okay. I'm beneath but capable. I'm not doing any tricks. I'm not going off any jumps. I might hit a box, but a box you just slide on
across.
And then you slide across. Yeah. Dude, look at his outfit. Is that not the most Tommy outfit you've ever seen?
Hell yeah!
Look at those things. Joe, what do you think of those?
That's awesome.
Badass, right? Yeah. Speaks.
Imagine seeing that coming down.
Oh, see that?
It's
a jet black helmet. I think he's got some 3D printed nightmare mask and these two big Angus Young from AC/DC looking horns.
Red devil horns.
One of those will be in my ass before so the end of the trip when he slides into me from behind.
Do you get altered in any way before heading, which is not advisable. It's very dangerous.
No. Usually my friends will prepare a big bowl of shrimp and we'll wash it down with some white wine. We have shrimp and white wine before we hit the mountain.
Good combo.
Someone will usually sneak a flask inside of their jacket. We'll take a nip or two on the way up the slopes. On the way down, we're giggling. What I have done this year, I didn't realize this, and I found this out the hard way last year. My wireless headphones, I had the Beats 3, mm-hmm. the $100 headphones, they don't work in the cold. They turn off.
Oh, they get too cold.
So I had to buy earbuds this year that do work in the cold. They're cold.
Or you put earmuffs on or something.
Do you know they make beanies
Bluetooth earmuffs
that have the headphones built into the things? Now, I thought about those.
When you are not on the mountain, are you always back at the house, or will you guys like hang out at the lodge and yuck it up with some people and hobnob? And
yeah, we'll spend the majority of the day at the resort, or the resort, the lodge, whatever. We'll start the day at my friend Sean's cabin. He's got some small family cabin. So we'll be there. We'll get breakfast. We'll spend the whole day at the mountain itself. And then at night, when the sun goes down, we'll probably get a few more runs before the mountain gets icy. Because when it gets cold, it gets wet, it gets icy. Then we'll go back home, more shrimp, more white wine, more deep philosophical conversations. Someone will cry. It'll probably be me. there's an X factor this year, though, and that's our dear friend Eric Woodworth. And Eric wants to go, and Eric has never snowboarded before. And he is not a guy that does anything in half measures. He's not going to bunny slope it. He's not going to green circle it. He's not going to just start out.
He'll just go wherever you guys go.
He's going to go to a black diamond the minute he gets there. And he is going to come down like a screamer.
Well, I don't know anything about snowboarding, but I know that when you do fall, you're either falling forward onto your knees or on your or backwards onto your ass. And if you fall enough, you are in a tremendous amount of pain.
Your butt bone gets so bruised. And luckily, he's got that big, thick Eastern ass of his. He's got one big old biscuit of a pillow back there. He's got some padding. He's good. He's also taken countless hits in rugby, so he knows how to fall.
True.
It's just, I'm thinking of the Gwyneth Paltrow story from when she, like, smacked into someone on the slopes.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot about that.
Yeah. And the guy was like, you know, you ran into me. No, you ran into me.
Yes.
I'm just thinking there's going to be some 11-year-old that's going to get trucked when this actual human Jeep Wrangler is coming down on a greased up knife. Yeah. That's what a snowboard is. You're riding a knife because you never really ride on the flat part of the board. You ride on the edge.
Yeah, of course.
And you go side to side. To your prior question, being a skater helped. Some of the abilities are similar, but
you
got
to learn how to get on that edge.
Exactly. You got to learn to ride the edge and all that.
Now, again, I can know how to ice skate and rollerblade. Would that translate
to
at all?
To skiing, I bet. Because you're going side by side and you're facing forward. You're going shoulder forward with a skateboard, shoulder forward with a snowboard. You on inlines, I bet you could ski.
Does any one of your crew ski instead
Sean
of snowboard?
Does. Sean skis.
Is he looked
well.
At differently?
No. He's very, very good. He's very talented. He shoots down the side of the mountain.
Skiing now reserved for older people.
No, it's. I think it's looked at as something that the wealthy might do. Snowboarders are looked at as sort of the punks of the mountain, and
still
the skiers. Yeah, you still catch strays. You're still catching murder ones from somebody.
The skiers don't like the snowboarders because we tear up the fresh powder.
Did you say we?
Yeah, snowboard.
Are you?
I'm sorry. What?
Are
you up to on Friday?
We tear up the
what
mountain?
Is that, you bitch? You'll be here.
You're a snowboarder?
Yeah. I took a
speak up. Hey, why don't you invite Joe? Bring Joe with you.
Friday?
You're expected to work on Friday.
Yeah, I got
to
be here.
It's supposed to be a getaway for
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You don't want to take me.
I'm supposed to remove myself from work. I don't need you running the Monday schedule by me when I'm on shrimp and late
one. When was the last time you snowboarded?
It's been a few years. I went out to Keystone in Colorado with a few buddies.
Dude, you've been in Colorado?
Yeah.
I hear that's crazy. I've never been anywhere outside of Maryland, Pennsylvania, or West Virginia. I hear that Colorado, I mean, in regards to snowboarding.
I mean, those are mountains.
I hear that powder is different.
It was incredible. Yeah.
That dude, Alex Buck, that used to be friends of the program, moved out there. He's getting his real estate modeling license, whatever the hell he does. Huge crank.
He just deadlifted 455.
Mm. Of course he did.
Yeah.
He hits the Colorado mountains, and you see some of that powder he's in.
Yeah.
It's like 4 or 5 feet deep. Now, I'm worried about injury because last week, and then I'm looking at some of the mountains now, the mountain was packed. It looked like a high school in between class periods. The amount of people on that mountain was disconcerting. That we were trying to get, we're going to go down there on Friday. We're actually Thursday night. Friday, we were just going to sled in, like, you know, snow tube. Saturday was going to be the big actual snowboard day.
Mm-hmm.
Tickets are completely sold out.
Wow.
Completely sold out, and we had to buy our mountain passes ahead of time. We had to buy our lift passes ahead of time because they're selling out. You can't just show up there on Saturday and get on. They'll turn you away. They're going to be at capacity, which is concerning, man, because it's not...
You're going to hurt yourself trying to avoid someone.
Yes.
That's what's
exactly, dude. You know how many people crack into each other at a skate park? You get some guy, he's trying to do a frontside 5-0 on a quarter pipe and just wreck some kid on a razor scooter. That's going to be Eric with some 13-year-old on the mountain.